vlog off with dinner. It is Monday, 6:35. About to eat some dinner and watch the second season of Top Boy. Catch y'all tomorrow. Catch me on the vlog doing regular shit. Sarkazz vlog. Crack-a-lack and party people, happy Tuesday, 8:35. 51 degrees on my way in. It's beautiful out here. Yeah, I hope you're having a wonderful week. Day, minute, hour, second. Whenever you see this, I appreciate each and every one of y'all for checking out my vlogs. If it's your first time here, I'm just doing everyday regular shit. Yeah, so it's not like something you wanna, yeah, tune in, come back again, subscribe, all that good stuff. Let's go. I need to get myself a cocoa butter. My shit finished. Fuck. I gotta keep turning the bottom to keep it up so the round part, the, you know, the thing don't cut up my mouth. Cause yeah, you know, y'all know. If you follow, you follow. But yeah, I gotta stop and pick one of them up. Time is moving fast. March 22nd, my last day on site until July. The 4th. Back in business. So this is what's supposed to fix my phone problems. I'm gonna go on the throne and read this before I do anything. Device deactivated in case. So the whole T-Mobile thing, the setup didn't happen correctly, so doing some troubleshooting, but I'll tackle the rest of that tomorrow when I get home later this evening. But the thing that I have to call Verizon, every time I reset my router now, ever since I changed my password, when I reset it, the blinking, it go back to the old password. So like when I reset it there to, you know, to try to get this whole thing, spotting thing work, this shit, yo, my Alexa's won't connect on the shit. I'm like, oh, this shit happened again. It changed my password again. Oh, so hurry up. They, yeah, I have to call Verizon and see why does that happen, because it's like it's saved, so like if I'm resetting the router, why the freak is it resetting it back to the old password? The font. People, 4:10 out of work. 43 degrees. It's a little chilly, son. This weather crazy. But I mean, hey, I take this than, you know, over snow any day. But still, are we supposed to be in spring now? But then, like, when spring hits, like, you get that nice thing. It's like a little cold, little session comes in, we spring into spring. I'm tired of this shit. This cold. Fuck. 1 minute I could take. What was it? On the weekend, Sunday. My hoodie, Lord, I was sweating like. Sweating. Was it sweating? Oh, then the drop. It's like 1 minute in the midday hot. Then it, this ridiculous. You gotta bring a change of clothes. I work hard for my ends, at times I gotta repent. Just got paid, now it's spent. Just got laid, now she vent. Call out sick, now we bent. Then we miss the... Happy Thursday. Alexa, what time is it?
It's 8:02 a.m. Have a good morning, Samantha.
Thank you. It was raining earlier. Alexa, what's the temperature?
Right now, it's 47 degrees Fahrenheit. Today, expect a high of 52 degrees.
Okay. So, I came back in the office. This shit still ain't load up. T-Mobile was supposed to call me back last night in 2 hours, didn't call me back. So now I'm about to go on the phone with T-Mobile because this shit pissing me off. Verizon did all they can, you know, did their part. Now, why this shit not, it's not loading up the way it's supposed to. And it's connected to the router, the modem. See, the one I have, this, what I have is the router modem one. This is basic. And everything is set up in there from yesterday. They had to log on my computer, log in to do something. And it shows up. It's connected to the internet. So how the fuck this shit ain't linking? The fuck? So, I tell you, it's like, I hate when you call a place and, you know, everyone you speak to tells you something different. Like, yo, what the hell y'all doing? So, I get a next person this morning. He's like, oh, so he went to see what's going on, why the cell spot not functioning the way it's supposed to. Oh, there's something that we have to unlock on our end. What? Why no one else ain't say that? Oh, I can't tell you why. You know, I've been doing this for 20 years and, you know, I'm used to this. And sometimes it's happened, you know, when they send out the cell spot, it's supposed to, you know, once you plug it up, it's supposed to, you know, go through the process and unlock and blah, blah, but sometimes it don't happen. Again, why the other two people ain't see that? So they're supposed to have a call back in 2 hours, this thing. He said, so on his, it should be going through the process and it should, you know, all lights should be green. We'll see. I said, y'all gonna do something. Y'all gonna do something because this shit is ridiculous. Here trying to make decisions because my car inspection is April. And I mean, I like that they changed it. Used to be like a specific date they would give you for your car inspection, but now you have to the end of the month that it's, you know, and mine is next month, but surgery is April. You know, surgery would have passed by now, but you know, I have to put my, because the car's gonna be sitting, I won't be driving for a little bit. Yeah, but with it, you know, within the 3 months of my recovery, I will be driving. But April, I ain't taking no car nowhere, and I ain't asking nobody. Yeah, so I'm trying to get everything done that I can. So I was like debating, should I do it this weekend or next weekend? Because I have one more weekend after this of where I'm able to do, I'm driving my, you know, self. So I think I'm gonna go and do the inspection today. One errand down. Let's go. Spoke to them. There's a lady in there right now. She said after her. No problem. Somebody just pulled up and pulled up behind the car. The guy was like, behind this vehicle. Yeah, they try to come and just, I'm here first. You gonna wait. Nigga. A nigga, please. He like, oh, you know, I got somewhere to go. I said, everyone got something to do. Nigga, go online. We all shit. The fuck. Go sit down, buddy. Dude is like, you can't come next month. I'm like, nigga, I'm gonna be in the hospital. I'm going into surgery. I can't do that shit. Think I'll try
this a new way. This is what you call dumb shit. This is what you call dumb shit. I'm tired of talking. And I need more of a show right now. It's time that you made your mind up. Cause lately all it ever does is change. Feels like we're only talking. Bitch, you hit my car, bitch. Hit my car. Fuck. Yeah. Hey, bless Jesus. You better turn that car right, girl. The fuck? Cause she turned in mighty close, anyways. The fuck? Second errand done. About to head back to Brooklyn now. And yeah, then head in. Not bad, 11:25. Yeah, get shit done and just get back to work. I'm working on, you know, remote because I can do a thing. Thank God, just from the phone. So we good. We good.
Took you for a one-night stand, and I was hoping to see you again, yeah. Maybe be a little more than friends, you and I, yeah. But lately you've been acting like a ghost, and never answer when I hit your phone. If you wanna go, just let me know. I guess I never should've let you in so close to my body. I should've known, just because you spent the night doesn't mean you want me. I should've known not to let my guard down so damn fast before even knowing what I really.
Awesome, 12:37, all errands done. Yeah, picked up lunch. Oxbot, yeah, busy morning. It's gonna be a busier now, yeah. Time to go home.
Same thing.
I'm so freaking annoyed with this T-Mobile shit. So they're telling me they're seeing that the ports are being blocked. But Verizon opened this shit up yesterday. They log on to my shit and I see. So I call Verizon, who's ever called back, because I ain't sending no hold for no 20 damn minutes. Some bullshit, man. 3 days with this. They say, yeah, have you seen you calling a lot? These, yeah, bitch. Oh, hey. Hello?
Hello,
yes.
Hi, this is Fred from T-Mobile.
Yes, Fred.
Are you home? Yes,
I am. And I was looking at the time I called T-Mobile because I'm like, nothing has happened. And so the T-Mobile people tell me, oh, Verizon is blocking the ports. But I'm saying,
no.
What the hell, like, what is good? This don't make any sense.
Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I ran a couple of diagnostics before I actually called you, okay?
Okay.
And it looks like the device is defective.
Oh, now I got a defective device. This is some shit.
I'm going to send some technicians to your area. They're not going to bother you at all.
Okay. What, that's something that's something done outside?
Yeah, it's gonna be outside. Yeah, they're not gonna go to your house at all. They're gonna go to the area and take a look at your phone connection to the network. So they're not gonna bother you at all, okay?
So, but. So you're gonna send me another one of these boxes because this is defective. But then you're telling me you don't even see why I need this box. And I don't even understand why I need this box. So this is weird. It's strong. It's strong. So I don't understand why the heck, again, because, again, I've never had any problems. If you look at my account, I never called T-Mobile like this.
Right.
So
I want to get this fixed for you. So I want to get my technicians out there.
Box that you're sending, the box you're sending, I could put this one back in, put this one in there?
Yeah.
So is it going to be a return label?
Yeah, there's going to be a return label.
Oh, okay, because I'm not paying to send anything back.
Right.
Okay.
Of course. Yeah, it's late six number.
Okay. Yeah, see, that's the problem. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, no, I hear it. I hear the problem right away. I'm going to place in a brief roll so I can call you the other number, okay?
No problem. All right, so it's ready to send back to these people. 3 days. And I don't get it. Like, why isn't everyone trained the same way? Because, you know, I just kept saying, send me the, can I go to tech support? Tech support. But the person I was talking to, the gentleman, he's specialized tech support. Now he ain't regular tech support. So I should be getting the new one tomorrow. And yeah. And it's like, I don't know if I recorded, but he was like, I don't even see why you even need that. Cause you're, yeah, I know my signals. This is why I didn't understand why the hell did I need this for. Like, so hopefully, y'all pray my strength, because, yo, I'm about ready. Like, say, fuck T-Mobile. But I don't like, I've been with Verizon. Sprint still exists? I don't think so. Who, Boost? No. Again, I've had no problem with T-Mobile until now. I've been with them 9 years. I've never, like, what in the hell? So, yeah, pray my strength, because this is really annoying. And I'm so glad I have a landline, because I'd be fucked. You know, annoying, but I can't hear your hand. You're breaking up. This shit is annoying. I just wanted to hang up the phone and be like, send me a telegram.